Parker. Line drives it down the field. One hop to Tim Forehand at about the 6. He will get back to about the 20, and that's it. 6 seconds left in the first half of play, and OU right now, after that last touchdown, 9-7 in front of the Miami Redskins.
You see the scoring...
Down, and Ohio U also got a touchdown, and some exciting touchdowns they were, both of them coming on fourth down conversion plays.
Miami's only touchdown coming with Mondo Costello. He caught a screen pass and scampered in from about 29 yards, and that was the Redskins' only score. And by the way, that was the first time they even scored a touchdown in the first quarter all season long.
And Ohio U, though, came right back, as you might recall, right before the end of that first half, set up by a beautiful punt return by Larry Hargrove of about 28 yards. And then Byron Cross caught that six-yard touchdown pass from Thornton that put OU up by 2 points at the half. And again, at that play of Mondo Costello, only the second touchdown pass, he had some great blocking out there in the flat. Matter of fact, number 20, Larry Hargrove, that we just mentioned on the punt return, was one of the guys beaten on that play as Miami got the seven-pointer, only its second touchdown passing so far in 1989. The Bobcats, as we said, holding to a two-point lead. You see some of the members of the Miami defense over there, John Wofford, number 50, as they played fairly well in the first half of play against this OU rushing game, which came in second best in the Mid-American Conference.
Particularly against the rush offenses. You see OU with only 38 yards to Miami's 74. That has to be one of the first times Miami has outrushed a team for a half the entire season long. The big surprise to both of us is the passing yards, though, from OU, 174 yards.
OU came into today's ball game, and that was one of the problems they had. They had passed for an average of about 142 a game. So here in the first half, they've already beaten their season average. But you see right below the pass yardage, a real story. Andrew Greer, their running back, fine running back, who's rushed for over 500 yards. He's already fumbled twice. Thornton fumbled once. And on the other side of the ball, Chris Alexander, coming back from injury for Miami, had a fumble on the opening series and another one later in that first half.
But the positive side for Chris Alexander is he has rushed 15 times for 72 yards, which is well over 4 yards of carry, which you have to do to be successful in the MAC rushing.
OU will kick off to start the second half of play. Chris Alexander and Tim Forehand, the two tailbacks, who have seen quite a bit of action in today's ball game, are going to be back deep as we start this second half of action. Doing the kicking off for Ohio U, their place kicker, Jim Delvern. And he missed a crucial extra point that was from 35 yards out because of a 15-yard unsportsmanlike penalty on Ohio U after their last touchdown. This kickoff comes to Forehand back at about his 2. Following the blocking right up the middle, it gets shoestring tackled out at about the 24-yard line. First and 10 from there for Miami. A good tackle by Dana Griffin, a backup fullback on the special teams. So Miami takes over first and 10 at about the 24-yard line.
Forehand very upset because he just got tripped up. He found a little seam, but he was tripped up by his feet. And as a result, he's only at the 25-yard line. He almost could have broken that all the way.
It wouldn't have been for that tackle that we mentioned there. It looked like Griffin was about to did get a hand on him to bring him down. So Miami starts right where he left off in the first half. He gets outside the other direction this time, all the way up to the 42-yard line for a gain of 10. So Alexander has...